Hello, little moon. Hi, fam. Welcome to my channel. Welcome to Cheska. In this channel, we will talk about books and sewing and sustainability and fashion and language learning and definitely the daily life of a 24-year-old. Now, let's get started. January. My January book was actually The Art of War. I will display the picture here or here, anywhere convenient in the screen. And I actually wanted just to kickstart the year with a push towards my creative side. And so I read that book really gives tough love advice, and so it did. So it did. But you know, some parts of the book were, I must say, at least me, I think it was written for a certain type of group, which doesn't necessarily mean you know, that it's very inclusive book, but well, at least that was from my point of view. And alright, so my most favorite line from this book is: preparation, order, patience, endurance, acting in the face of fear and failure. No excuses, no bullshit. So, and also, we're never alone. And also, it is one thing to study war and another to live the warrior's life. So I think the third one is really my most favorite line from this book. And it really shows you how powerful is the writing in this book. And so I recommend it for anyone who's, you know, kind of struggling with their creative juices. Give this book a read, and I think that it will really get you out of that slump, at least for the thinking portion. Yeah. And all right, third book of the year. Third book of the year is this precious baby right here, The Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. Now, this book really takes you back to Troy. I read Troy when I was in high school. I've watched the movie, I've watched the series about it. But Madeline Miller was able to renew my experience of Troy, and she was able to really tell the story of Achilles and Patroclus and Briseis and such a different part, and I really never expected that the tale would turn out that way, but I was happy that it did, because it was amazing. I was seeing a different point of view, a different take on these characters, and it was just refreshing. This was written in a very poetic kind of manner, not as much as Margaret Atwood's writing, but quite close. Okay, here is my favorite line. This is what all mortals ask first. In disbelief, shock, fear. Is there no exception for me? So I am terribly guilty of that. So yeah, that's the line I love the most from this book. I recommend you, I highly recommend you to try out The Song of Achilles if you are interested in Greek mythology. And my February book is The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. I couldn't resist not trying out this book. It was amazing, really. I think I gave it 5 out of 5 stars in my Goodreads account. And yes, I will also link down my Goodreads account down below. Please be sure to check it out. And if you like it, check it out. And if you don't want to check it out, that's okay too. Yeah, so in my Goodreads account, you'll see all of my reviews since I've joined Goodreads, which I think was last year. And so yeah, there's quite a lot of good stuff in there. And anyway, I digress. So Evelyn is really a powerful character. She will make you hate her, and then she will make you fall in love with her. That's her magic. She's really the kind of woman who creates opportunity to make something she wants happen, and she's not afraid to put herself at the mercy of her fate. And unfortunately, I don't have a physical book right now because I borrowed it from my sweet, sweet cousin who is watching. If she's watching right now, hi Chloe. Yeah, she actually owned that book, and she let me highlight it, which was so precious, so precious. And so I really don't remember the exact way that my favorite line was written, but it goes with something like, when you have a dream, you have to be able to understand, and you have to be able to put yourself at the mercy of your dream, which is, you know, what I just said earlier. And also, I also like the line, be wary of a man who has something to prove. Yeah, I think that is a very important reminder to a lot of people. Yeah, so that's just me. Okay. So that's my February book, and now let's move on to my other February book, because I read The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo and Reese, and so I needed another February book, which is this one. Of course it is, right? Now I have the whole series not here, not on the shelf, it's on that shelf right there, but I put off reading this book since I got this, so maybe 4 or 5 years now, I've put up reading this just because I can't let go of the original story. I can't let go of the original series. It's too precious. I was scared that this might, you know, kind of let me down. And I must say that honestly, it kind of did. I've already figured out halfway through what's gonna happen and how it's gonna end, but you know, the magic is still there. I always love Harry Potter and anything that they can really produce out of the world. And so yeah, Harry Potter and the Curls and the Curls Harry Potter and the Cursed Child by these fantastic authors right here was, I think, a 3 out of 5 for me in Goodreads. But nonetheless, you know, the magic. It's the magic. And let me check. When I read these books, I always highlight the magic spells as well. So, you know, I might need them someday. Okay, so my favorite line is lost and hopeful all at once. Well, one of you know, the best lines I read in this book. And I could really relate. Sometimes I am both lost and hopeful all at once. And so, yeah, that's Harry Potter. And now, the next book I want to talk about is so, so special to me. I discovered this book when I was watching my favorite YouTuber, Lexi. I'll link her channel down below as well. She's absolutely fantastic, and she included this book in her books that I would that I would die for, I think, something like that. I'll link it down below. It's a really fun video, and I discovered this book. Are you seeing it? Oh gosh, I hope you're seeing it. So this book is called Bunny, and it's by Mona Awad, and oh my goodness, Bunny. What can I say about this book? It's amazing. It's gritty. It's gore. It's also very cutesy. Not in a bad way at all. The writing is absolutely fantastic. Mona Awad really did not hold back at all in terms of her writing. So this book is about Samantha, and she's in a prestigious, She's in a prestigious writing school, and there's this group of girls, they call themselves Benny, and at first she kind of hated them, and then she realized she wanted to be them, and then she hated them again. So it's just, it's absolutely fantastic. It's like Mean Girls in Scream Queens, if they get a baby, beat this book, but so much better. This is a jewel. It's really hands down to Mona Awad. And also I bought this because Margaret Atwood is in the cover of the book with her comment here, and I love Margaret Atwood, I trust her face, and yet again she did not fail me at all. So alright, let's see here. My favorite, really, I can't even pick. I underlined, highlighted so many lines. So I think my most favorite is Need My Love is a Whole Other Story, which is entirely true. Sometimes we want things but we don't need them, right? And so it's so simple, but it's perfect. It's just perfect the way Mona Awad wrote it. So yeah, that's Bunny by Mona Awad. Please read this book, please. And then the fourth book that I've read is again an ebook. It's Invisible Influence by Kevin Coleman, and it's an introductory kind of book, I would say, for those people curious about marketing strategies. It's a really interesting book, I must say. It's mostly composed of Kevin Hogan's, I would say, observations, experiences, studies over the years in his field, which is obviously marketing. And the most interesting part for me was when he has written, I think the first part was very interesting for me. He wrote that we often end up with people who have the same initials as our name or is very close to it. So it made me think, you know, it made me introspect a little about my love life. And was it far as close? I think quite far, so I guess that's why. But yeah, it's really the most interesting part for me. But all the other studies or observations, shall I say, that he put in the book were also quite interesting as well. Now, let's move on to my favorite line. My favorite line is, when is typically far more important than what or how? Which is absolutely true. Timing, and don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and comment down below for anything really, perhaps suggestions about books to read. I always love that. And yeah, do let me know what can be my next book video about, and I will surely take a look at your comments. Alright, let's continue to the Crimes of Grindelwald. I had to read this before I watched the third installment of the series. And just like the previous magical book we had in here, well, of course I watched the movie, so I guess that's why I was able to put the pen in. Okay, let's move through that realization. So honestly, the new installation from the magical world is not as satisfying as the original ones. I guess I still cling and subscribe to, you know, the new magical era, which is really, you know, a prequel to the original series, because of really the magic. Joe is able to really pull us into that. That enchantment of hers. She was able to bewitch all of us, and it's really a place of comfort for me. And so I guess that's how I keep reading this. Honestly, I liked reading the screenplay better than watching the movie. I guess it's because, you know, I can highlight things and draw things in the book, which really makes it so personal to me, like this. And this is a hardbound ass book, which, you know, so pretty. So pretty. And my favorite line from this book is, here we go. Actually, it's a scene. It's not really very profound. But Dumbledore is looking at the pictures. These memories are agony. He's full of remorse, but also nostalgia. For the only time in his life, he felt fully understood. So see, that gave me quite a clue on, you know, what's gonna happen in the third movie. That gave me quite a clue on, like, who Dumbledore really is. So, you know, wink, wink. I haven't watched the third movie, but yeah, that's the Crimes of Grindelwald by J.K. Rowling. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and comment down below for anything really, perhaps suggestions about books to read. I always, always love that. And yeah, do let me know what can be my next book video about, and I will surely take a look at your comments. Alright, let's continue to the video. Now, the next book I've read is another e-book, The Metamorphosis by Franz Kafka. And I've always been curious about this book. I must say, it's very absurd. I was confused most of the time when I was reading it. I can follow the story, but the thing is, there was no background whatsoever as to why Greg Samsa turned into a cockroach. And everybody just accepted it. And it was just weird to me. But honestly, I love the ending. I love the ending because I think it's amazing that a woman was able to take charge at the end of the story. You'll see. So yeah, I was confused, yeah, but I guess I was satisfied with the ending. Also, I wanted to read a Kafka work because of the current book that I'm reading, and I will devote it later. Now, my favorite line is about the metamorphosis. It's, hold on, let's see. Here we go. Calm, in need of calmest reflection, might be better than most confused decision. Which is, of course, I get absolutely very true. So that's for the metamorphosis. Now, the second to the last book I have read so far for this year was a slow burn. In fact, I read it in installments. I started it around, let's see, I think I started it around March, and I finished it around May, I think, and it's It by Stephen King. It's really slow burn, but, here's a big but, because it's a big book. The way that King was able to tell the story from the point of view of these five children, and then the five adults, and then it. And the way he was able to really create dairy. He was able to scare me at night and at noon. It was really such an experience, and I never regret reading that 700 plus page book because it was amazing. It was long, it was very long. I'm not sure why it had to be that long, but everything connected. Stephen King was able to tie down every knot that he was able to, let's just say he was able to close down every hole that he created in that world of his, and it was truly scary. I am scared of Pennywise, honestly. Okay. Now. Here we go. My favorite line is, "I love you too," he said. And what else counts? Right? It's scary, and then it's romantic, and then it's funny. That's it. Literally it. Now, the second to the last book I have read so far for this year was a slow burn. In fact, I read it in installments. I started it around, let's see, I think I started it around March, and I finished it around May. Around May, I think. And it's It by Stephen King. It's really a slow burn, but here's a big but, because it's a big book. The way that King was able to tell the story from the point of view of these five children, and then the five adults, and then it. And the way he was able to really create dairy, the way he was able to scare me at night and at noon, was really such an experience. And I never regret reading that 700 plus page book because it was amazing. It was long, it was very long. I'm not sure why it had to be that long, but everything connected. Stephen King was able to tie down every knot that he was able to, let's just say he was able to close down every hole that he created in that world of his, and it was truly scary. I am scared of Pennywise, honestly. Okay. Now. Here we go. My favorite line is, "I love you too," he said. And what else counts? Right? It's scary, and then it's romantic, and then it's funny. That's it. Literally it. Okay. And the last book that I read before June started is Big Little Lies by Leanne Moriarty. I was hesitant to read this because this was my auntie's, and well, it's a fat kind of book. It's a huge book. But I guess I didn't really know that the decks were so large. And it's absolutely brilliant. I was never for a second bored when I was reading this book. I just wanted to know what the three characters were thinking, what Maggie, Celeste, and Jane are going to do. Favorite line from Big Little Lies. Hold on. I almost forgot. Where is my most favorite line? Okay. She'd swallowed it whole and pretended it meant nothing, and therefore it had come to mean everything. So true. So true. Sometimes when you ignore something and it consumes you, which is, you know, why you want to ignore it, but then it does opposite. So that's my favorite line from Big Little Lies. We have reached the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching, liking, subscribing, hitting the notification bell, and commenting down below. Thank you, friends. Thank you, fam. Merci tout le monde. And I will see you back again soon with another video. Alright. Bye. Salut.